The answer is that L is recognizable. A machine that recognizes L is fairly simple. It just feeds the input 100010 into M and then accepts after M halts. If M loops, then so will this machine. If it doesn't loop, then this machine will accept. Note that it's not clear if it's possible to recognize the complement. If you haven't taken a class on the theory of computation before, then you might think it possible that there are only some dozens or hundreds of ways that infinite loops occur, and that you could check all of those cases. This is at least unclear, and as we'll see later, it actually turns out to be false. Simulation deferred to recognize in this language doesn't work either. We can't just run the machine and wait until it doesn't halt. That doesn't make any sense. Another possible idea is to monitor the machine by keeping track of every configuration it has been in, and if it ever repeats a configuration, to declare that it doesn't halt. This might detect some non-halting behavior, but because a Turing machine's tape is infinite, it can run forever without actually ever repeating a configuration.
Students will sometimes object that this strategy of monitoring for loops would work on any computer with finite memory. The trouble is that it would require more memory than the machine being monitored would have access to. So the monitor would have to be a different computational model than the machine it's monitoring. As a practical method of detecting cycles, this strategy doesn't work either. Consider the fact that a computer with a gigabyte of RAM has over 8 billion bits, and therefore over 2 to the 8 billion possible configurations. That's a lot of possible configurations before you detect a cycle. The bottom line is that this objection isn't satisfactory either in theory or in practice. Monitoring and looking for cycles of configurations just doesn't cut it.